Andres, can you tell us what is the difference between a flexible sigmoidoscopy and a full colonoscopy?
That's a very good question, and we're asked that frequently. Basically, the difference between these two modalities is the amount of colon that you're going to be visualizing. The colon is divided in different portions. You can see it as right colon and left colon. You can see it as ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and then the sigmoid in the rectum. When you're doing a flexible sigmoidoscopy, you're basically looking at the left part of the colon, and you're leaving everything that is a transverse and the ascending colon out. And these are areas that potentially may have a lesion, may potentially have a tumor as well, that you may miss if you only do a flexible sigmoidoscopy. When you do a colonoscopy, you are examining the whole length of the colon. And the whole length of the colon, it's more or less 1.5 meters, which is also 4 or 5 feet, you know, long. And it varies also if you're a female, if you're a man, if you are tall, if you are short. But the main difference is the extent of the colon that you are going to be evaluating, that you are going to be seeing during the procedure.
Andres, another difference with a flexible sigmoidoscopy compared to the colonoscopy is the type of bowel prep. For a flexible sigmoidoscopy, you might need to do an enema, whereas for a full colonoscopy, you have to do a full bowel prep. Now, regardless of which test you do, the bowel prep is critical for the doctor to be able to see what we want to see, which is the colon.